गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू दिस ऑनलाइन लेक्चर ऑफ इंग्लिश। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, इन लास्ट वीडियो लेक्चर वी स्टडीड द राइटिंग स्किल। फर्स्ट राइटिंग स्किल 3.1, समरी राइटिंग। इन टुडेज लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न सेक्शन 4, इट इज जनरे ड्रामा और नॉवेल। In today's lecture, we are going to discuss on history of novel. Dear student, you know what is novel? You read any novel? Yes, because number of students, those are interested to reading a novel. So, what is the novel? In 12th standard, we have to study the history of novel. Then some specific example of the novel, which is also given to you for our better study. So let's start today's lecture, history of novel. Look at on the screen, here the brief history is given. Before that, I would like to explain some important history of novel. Novel with origin dating back to poetic prose from a thousand of years ago. Mostly it is started from 16th century or the mid 17th century. An episodic central figure adventures from the Spanish Don Quixote era. Novel writing is an art form that has long been an integral part of the culture. Yet just because novel writing predates many long established civilization, you should not be discouraged from pursuing your dream. Rather, much evidence points to this fact that even a first time novelist can achieve great success. Even if success takes the form of personal gratification, that should prove to be a sufficient enough payoff to carry you forward as you embark on this exciting and immensely fulfilling journey. The question, what is novel? Which accumulated by a fictional prose narrative by considering length, typically having a plot that is unfolded by the action, speech and thoughts of the characters. The literary genres represented by the novels. It is derived from the Latin word novelia. Its meaning the formalized term novel was not used until the 18th century. In this infancy, the term was used during the medieval period as a literary classification to describe a shortened tale that relayed a generalized sentiments reflective of the society at large. In short, the goal of a novel is to offer the reader a streamlined, cohesive story in which all of the components seamlessly combine to present a statement on the human condition. In our contemporary world, the use of novel has shifted to focus more on the central character than on the plot. Also playing a defining role in the novel is the sense of realism. Although novels are developed as a fictional stories, the underlying element inherent in all art is based upon human behavior and the ways in which we interact with others. Thus, in line with this definition, the plot lines of a novel, though referring to a fictional universe, it need to be plausible in the sense they could happen in everyday life. Example of such humanistic elements including using local time sequence, conventional ideas, etc. Necessity of travel to distance, locals, money, or the barter, you know, barter system means exchange of the goods. It was the traditional system in ancient age. To purchase goods and services, a 24-hour period being composed of phases of day and night. According to the novel which accumulated by the different types of the features, such as a whole, the three primary features of the traditional novel, which include a cohesive, believable plot structure, second one, well-defined, credible characters, and third one, a strong undercurrent of reality. It has been said that a work of fiction is measured by how well or poorly the author is able to unify the story and control its impact. Therefore, the only obligation of the writer is to make the story flow well of the writer and have strong elements of interest. Although the realism element may be consistent among all novels, a range of the other qualities may be used at differentiate one from another. For example, which one aim of some novels may be to entertain its readers, others may strive to engage and stimulate readers in an effort to expand their conscious awareness of the greater world in which they live. Others may aspire to reach readers on a more emotional and a psychological level by presenting humanistic references in terms of the form of conflicts, fears, and desires. According to John Brand, the British novelist popular during the 1950s, the novel is the most variable of literary forms, for it has no hard and fast rules about subject, techniques, and purpose. Now let's see some classic examples of novel. Over the years, novels that have remained in our minds and hearts to earn the title of classic include Jane Austen's novel Sense and Sensibility, which is written in 1811, and Pride and Prejudice, which is written in 1813. Then Charlotte Bronte's Jane Eyre, which is written in 1847. Emily Bronte's Wuthering Heights, which was written in 1847. Then Nathaniel Hawthorne's The Scarlet Letter, which is written in 1850. Then Herman's Melville's Moby Dick, which is written in 1851. Mark Twain's Adventures of Huckleberry Finn, which is written in 1884. For Scott Fitzgerald's The Great Gatsby, which is written in 1925. Then Ernest Hemingway's The Sun Also Rises, which is written in 1926. William Faulkner's The Sound and the Fury, which is written in 1929. And John Steinbeck's The Grapes of Wrath, which is written in 1931. All of these, anyone you read any novel, if you are not read, please read this novel. This is very important. This is the very important work in classical age of the novel. According to the Mark Twain, a novel definitions by multiple masters, according to the Nathaniel Hawthorne, as a work of art, though a novel must conform to certain laws and rules, it also bears the burden of having to be brutally truthful, albeit truthful based upon the writer's own set of circumstances. It was Henry James' contention that the purpose of a novel is that of representing life. In Randall Jarrell's famous definition, he viewed novels as prose narratives of some length that reflect real-life situation involving some form of conflict. Within the literary work, in the art of fiction, John Gardner proclaim a novel to be akin to a symphony in the sense that is closing moment echoes and resounds with all that has gone before. Gardner surmised that the conclusion of a novel reveals hidden connection and causes that a life for the time being becomes unified and organized. Perhaps most significantly, the novel's respective characters, motives and plans became evident, and we as the readers learn the consequence of free will. According to the novelist Anthony Burgess, he was an English novelist, critic and man of letters whose fictional explorations of modern dilemmas combine wit, moral earnestness and a note of bizarres. Novel, it has established mood, motivation, characterization and style with Clifton Fadiman's and actors. With the aid of noted actors from the Old Vic Company, American editor and anthologist Clifton Fadiman explained the novel's elements of motivation, characterization and style, and also shows how mood is established. This is 1962 production of Encyclopedias, Britannia's Educational Corporation. A novel and invented a prose narrative of considerable length and a certain complexity that deals imaginatively with human experience, usually through a connected sequence of events involving a group of persons in a specific setting. Within its broad framework, the genre of the novel has encompassed an extensive range of types and style. A picaresque novel, epistolary novel, gothic novel, romantic novel, realistic novel, historical novel, to name only some of the more important ones. The novel is genre of fiction, and the fiction may define as the art or a craft of contriving through the written word, representation of human life that instruct or divert or both. The various forms that fiction may take are best seen less as a number of separate categories than as a continuum, or more accurately climbed with some such brief form as the anecdote at one end of the scale and the longest conceivable novel at the other. When any piece of fiction is long enough to constitute a whole book as opposed to a mere part of a book, then it may be said to have achieved a novelhood, but this state admits of its own quantitative categories, so that a relatively brief novel may be termed a novelia. If the insubstantiality of the content matches its brevity, or a novelette, and a very long novel may overflow the banks of a single volume and become a Roman flue or river novel. Length is very much of the dimension of the genre. The term novel is a truncation of the Italian word novellia from the pure word, Latin words novellus, a late variant of novus meaning new. So that what is now in most language a diminutive denotes historically the parent form. The novellia was a kind of enlarged anecdote like those to be found in the 14th century Italian classic Boccaccio's Dreamerian, each of which exemplifies the etymology well enough. Stories are little new things, novelties, freshly minted diversions, toys. They are not reworking of those fables or myths, and they are lacking in wealth and moral earnestness. It is to be noted that despite the high examples of the novelist of the most profound seriousness, such as Tolstoy's Henry James and Virginia Woolf, the term novel still in some quarters carries overtones of lightness, of frivolity. And it is possible to describe a tendency to triviality in the form itself. The odd or symphony seems to possess an inner mechanism that protects it from aesthetic or moral corruption. But the novel can descend to shameful commercial depth of sentimentality of pornography, also known as all-purpose medium, catering from the stanza of the such early ancient Roman fiction as Petronius Saturnus of the 1st century AD, the Lucius Appuleius Golden Age in the 2nd century contains many of the popular elements and distinguishes the novel from its nobler. Born relative to the epic poem, in the fictional work, the medium is prose, the event described are unheroic, the settings are street and taverns, not battlefields and palaces. There is more low fornications than princely combat. The gods do not move the action. The dialogue is homely rather than articulistic. It was in fact out of the need to find in the period of the Roman decline a literary form that was anti-epic in both substances and language, that the first prose fiction in Europe seems to have been conceived. The most memorable character in Petronius in Novellia Ricci, Vulgarian, the hero, the Lucius Appuleius, is the turn into a donkey. Nothing less epic can well be Emmanuel. So in this lecture we studied a short history of the novel. In the next lecture we will see the elements of the novel and other related information of the novel. Thank you.